Yo, this your boy, the Super Son, the Super Matter. The camera gal, the camera queen, we're gonna call it the camera queen, the KK. Her camera went out on me in the middle of trying to talk to the young brother about Yahshua, but it's all good. So we back on 22nd Street. Put that over there. All of them was like little businesses. They had the jazz, a little jazzy club, a little restaurant, something else. All that was all so-called black business. This right here is a mango tree. Y'all see this? See the color of these leaves? It's the Moorish color. Mango, baby. That burgundy and green, red and green. You know what I mean? Now check this out. Look at this across the street over this over here. You see him? You see him? You see how the mangoes? Look at that. And we go out through the red bricks again. And we crossing the red brick, even though these are fake kind of red bricks, they ain't the original red bricks, we're gonna cross right here. And stuff, but all this was live back in the days when I grew up, a little boy coming around here with grandma's house, coming out here playing around. And I told you, I used to walk down the streets, and we walked down the streets, we had food to eat. See what I'm talking about? Look how they see the mango trees.
Mm-hmm.
This is how I was when I was young, but they just growing though. Look how they're hanging. Look how they're hanging. This tree been here for years since I was a little child. Look at these things growing, all these mangoes. You know what I mean? This was the whole neighborhood was like this. Mangoes, you found watermelons down, walking down the street and stuff like that. You still got a lot of mango trees. You got a lot of mango trees still around here, but it's not like it used to be like now. Nah, this is like a little domino spot thing. But I think it was a barbershop back in the day. I can't remember what this was back in the days. So, what's up, bro? All right. But this right here, all these was business and stuff. All some kind of business. Like I think that one was like helping people start business right there. The building right there. I can't remember. I was a little child, you know.
Remember when I came
out of the military, a lot of this stuff was still going on, but it's in the dead end process. So this is why I used to get my hustle on out here. I ran this block from here, from that, whatever, interstate down to a street down there, 21st Avenue. That, I own that. This is my so-called real estate. One of them people be talking about real estate, and I had a lot of people just work, you know. It was real talk, they don't lie. A lot of people doing their thing, but I came in and changed the game. And gave everybody work. Okay. But now it's everything kind of dead out. See, ain't no children in the streets because all of them dead. People don't understand. You don't see people out because they're really zombies. They're dead when the ones you see out is dead. You know, it ain't no life force out here. Everything is dying out. This was always once a beautiful area called the Ybor City, and then they turned into like a drug infested thing. And stuff and made it crime written and stuff like that, locked a lot of people away. So then they can get rid of the children and the seeds, then they come back in and replant and rebuy the homes. I told you, whatever area you're in, go buy old homes, look for the old buildings, the old homes. They got what they call restoration money, and you can get these old homes real cheap and start rebuilding your cities up because these are your ancestors' home. They got seeds and messages all through these homes and woods and stuff like that. All these little home properties right here, they all going down and stuff now. And then somebody come in, they're gonna buy them up for the, no offense to the China man, or so-called European, come in and get a little place to put little cheap-ass homes on them. These cheap, look at the building. They've been here like since 1915. They still up, right?
Mm-hmm.
That was a game room for the children and a small kind of store like sold foods and stuff like that, sandwiches. Cuban sandwiches, see the windows, they sold sandwiches out the windows right there. Called Cuban sandwiches and stuff like that, which is famous down here. And this was another store and stuff like this. A convenience store, which had real groceries inside it. This is our grocery store in the hood. This building right here. There's nothing now. This is where the Domino's guys used to play, an old man played Domino's. And there's like a big house there that had a property and let people pay money to have different games set up there, old man set there. That's where my granddad messed up somebody there. Back in the day, because they were gonna try to rob my granddad and stuff. But see these cheap ass homes?
Mm-hmm.
That ain't real wood. They ain't gonna last. Hurricane come knock that shit down because it's not nature. Hurricane never knocked none of these wooden homes down. The reason hurricane don't knock the wooden homes down because the wood came from earth. And it was so much wood that you could take from earth and deal it with the saltwater wood. You know, they was doing it in the saltwater stuff. It was connected to earth. So the spirit didn't come and knock them down because, you know, the children was inside the old wooden homes. So some people try to say, oh, them was slavery homes. No, them was Negro homes, so-called black man homes, because it was connected to earth. And the little wooden homes, there weren't no slaves. Man, that was our shit. And now today you try to live in cement to wonder why you sick. Nigga, you ain't in the sea and you ain't got no mint. But you in a cement home. Get the hell out of here with that bull crap. Look at these fake red bricks. Them fake red bricks. They ain't no real clay though. That's some fake ass crap. That's guys pausing and getting people sick out here. I started going down the street with my where I live at. Look at this here. Stop over paying TV. This house been here for a long time. You got lights still put up in here. All this stuff going now. They're supposed to try to knock it down, make a grocery store or something out here and stuff, but the old man like that said he ain't selling his property. He said, he ain't selling nothing. But they try to put these new things to make everything new, but you're trying to make things new at the same time when stuff real old and raggedy and stuff that you and tore up, the government tore it up. They did. They the ones posing the hoods and stuff like that. They the ones put the stores in the area where certain beer, they have barcodes on it. Bad stuff go to poor areas on purpose. So if you people out there that drink, you know, if you still doing that behind closed doors, that's your own business. I don't knock people what they do behind closed doors. I talk about what you do out here in these streets. What you do behind closed doors is your own business. So if you going to get you something to drink, go into a little richer area and get it and take it all the way home with you. Don't buy no beer and stuff out of no poor areas because that's a poison. Yeah. And that place right here, coming up as a Florida Sentinel. Well, that was the first so-called black newspaper, I think, in the state of Florida, to be honest. That's C. Black Andrews. He like part of the family, not our blood family, but my daddy, them partners, dealing with the Moorish man's business. And they opened Lily White. It's a group of them, they're businessmen. Like, oh, there was Moors. Not that Freemasonic little dudes that wear them fez hats. Real boy, that's my daughter. Is that her in that little car?
Where?
That little blue car. She didn't blow the horn. Nah, that ain't her. I don't see no heads in that waving. She would've blew a horn at me. Yeah, nah, that ain't her. She at work. She works so much, poor little thing. Just like her daddy. That Capricorn, that so-called boy, Capricorn blue. Workaholic. Yeah, every day, work, work, work. All right, okay. See, those trees been a long time. But, see all the things? There's a Florida Sentinel bulletin, where the paper, where Nova Joali sit down and gave him a roll, put a roll behind his name now. In legislation, they put a roll behind his name. All this right here was a bar right down that corner. That jeans bar, and there's a cleaners and a barbecue place behind it. All of it's gone. All this is black, so-called black businesses and stuff. See, they're trying to open stuff back up. But everything they're making now is the church shit. Oh, I got to take it down there to the thing. See the Tuhuckin, down in the middle?
Where?
Tampa.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wanted to see that sign, huh? Let's go this way. I wanted to see the sign, the Florida Tuhuckin sign. Now, this is all about Eric before it starts on getting to the project side. But that's the Florida Sentinel thing right now. That's the paper. That's the paper, so-called black paper thing. Everybody need their paper. They came with the Tampa Tribune. They got Tampa Tribune. They got the Tampa Times. The St. Pete Times. So they can flood your mind with their papers. So we had our papers, but our paper ain't doing nothing but have funeral shit. All the funeral shit and advertising for churches. It ain't no business stuff. It ain't nothing about life. It's about death, death and a beauty of the week and some bad foods and fat people. Yeah. Well, I like these cactuses.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they look almost like aloe stuff. But this was like a little motel thing from back in the days.
That's old, huh?
Yeah, you can tell it's an old house. Look at it. Look, they just let everything go down. It was like an old house back in the days on a little motel thing. Like, people like, what do people call them? Singers like Ray Charles and stuff. Ray Charles stayed right down here. These was projects then. But way down the other end, Ray Charles' grandma was dying in the projects. People don't know that. Then over there, another project set, lady named Cheryl. That lady say, sing that song. That one Puff Daddy and use that beat. Cheryl something, she's over there in the projects too. A lot of them down here, goddamn, came out of this area. They don't know about it. They just moved to another town.
We built a lot of stuff here.
Now here's the roundabout.
I seen pictures when I wasn't born in my grandma's house.
It was palm trees all down this road. See how the middle thing was? It was palm trees from here and went down in the road split right here. And it took you down to that park where the water at, where we rode the bicycles at. That's called the Soto Park now. It was called Palmetto Beach. And so that was the main beach in Tampa. So all black people and all this kind of stuff. And when the hurricane came in the 1920s, messed all that junk up. That's when everything started changing. And now they built a loop called McKay Bay and everything else and all this bull crap. But see what I say, 1911?
Mm-hmm.
Nova Drive, 1913, right?
Yeah.
So it's showing you how this area was being all created with the so-called black people and all business stuff. We had it going on then. The Moors had it going on all around. There's more people, this is a lost history. Now they go right here calling themselves black and all running to be saved by Jesus. No goddamn Jesus out here. Jesus is a false Christ. I tell you. The false Christ coming. Joshua was not called no Christ. He's a Mashiach. So, who come with this word, this Christ thing? Christ has come from Christ out of ancient Kibbutz. Who come with this Christ thing? Something gonna rise from the dead. Ain't gonna rise from the dead, but a goddamn vampire. Stealing people goddamn souls. But this right here, this is an energy center in Tampa.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on. Camera girl. Hold on, right, welcome to the road. Hold this right here for me.
These supposed to be like little new home things, supposed to be like project things now, right? Look.
Outside on a Sunday, Saturday. There's nobody here now. Nobody sees this.
You just see one child on a bicycle, riding on a bicycle. That's it.
There's nobody outside no more.
This was the project. It was full of people and children. Where's children at, there's life at. When there ain't no children out there anyway, life is dying.
Mm-hmm.
People don't see that. Come on, let's go this way. We're going to the hospital.
Yeah. There's no more life out here. And nobody sees this.
But they swear, it's getting better, it's getting good.
I walked to the old halls. See, this on the street, and they stopped off the, what to call it, where they separated this house is on this side, and the PJ's on this side. And I ain't gonna take y'all into the history out there. Well, the store used to be at this stuff, where I had a shootout when I first got in town. It was a heroin hole. And I didn't know it, I was dropping a girl off from the club or something like that. I wanna stay around the corner. I should have walked by my house while I stayed there with the garage and stuff. Cause I used to do some juggling back up in the garage and hide my car. But that building, when I see that brown fence up there, that was like a heroin hole at the store. And when I came out here, they said it was the worst projects in the United States of America. I think it was the worst in the world. It was called Ponce de Leon and College Hill. They called it Vietnam. And I thought it was a joke. So I rolled through the thing, I'm like, good God, that shit was worse than overseas. I mean, I've been to some third world places and this was worse. And this was right here inside the area. So it was to kill this whole energy center off. Cause the project was all townhomes. Upstairs, downstairs, upstairs, with two bedrooms upstairs with a bathroom, a bedroom downstairs. You can't find no place like that. The townhomes, the condos. And they turned them to hell. Yeah. We're walking around this way. I ain't going over there right now.
Yeah, but the energy in this whole area was real good, and the government turned it real bad by flooding it with drugs and stuff, and that heroin. It was the heroin stuff that was doing all the most killing, because they the ones started acting all crazy with the needles. They put that silver needle. That's like what they call it, that thing from the alien thing, like how alien had ladies shoot the needles into their necks and back.
Mm-hmm.
That's what the needle is. That's all alien technology. Yeah, that ain't no goddamn organic stuff. You putting that metal inside your body, you're metallic human. You ain't real, you're a robot. They already automated you. So time they put a vaccination shot in you, really them needles ain't nothing but automation. I mean, everybody had needles. So I got hundreds popped in my arms out there in the military stuff. Yeah, but that's all that is. But now that, I walk through the, they changed it up, but you can see how it just, it's bad. You can see real pretty and stuff. This one for the beautiful area. All right, well, I'm going to put the house there. But yeah, that's going to be about it on this one. I'll walk on, finna walk along toward the house. Yeah.
That's it?
Yeah, but, you know, back in the days, how it used to be, these were like the homes, they've been here at all. And the projects were behind them and stuff like that. And some people, oh, I think later, they've been up for a long time. Some people been here forever. Yeah.
How you doing?
Hey, how you doing, boss man? All right. Yeah. But, the homes all had nice, everybody. Home has like what they call it, a lot. That's what a home called a lot. And people don't understand, lot comes out the Bible. You know that? People don't understand that. A lot, L-O-T, lot, that's a lot. You're supposed to get like a lot of land. And this is written, but nobody don't know this because they're following the system of a goddamn devil, letting this devil take your goddamn land. You're supposed to have a lot of land. Everybody's supposed to be decreed for a lot of land. This is biblically written. This is the kind of crap that I'm working on. What I gotta do to study is try to get the codes right. But only how I can get the codes right if the people are righteous. And once you got a whole group of people, enough people signed up, righteous, as in the membership association, they gonna get their lots of lands. Everybody deserve a lot of land. This is written, they don't got that thing right. Anybody gonna put no money down there, you connect to a group, you're supposed to get that lot of land. But see, the Catholic people, they smart. They got the same codes and got everything. Hey, how you doing, man?
Hey, how you doing,
Dave? Just fine, thank you. Right. So the Catholic, what they did, they got groups of people. So now they got their big groups association, members association, the Catholic. The Catholic is nothing but the Jews nothing but the Christians. The Judaic Christians is nothing but the same people. That's JC, Jesus Christ. All this bullshit. So they got trickery and start taking Yahshua children lots of lands all over the earth. You own earth. You're the children of earth. If you follow Yahshua HaMashiach, you own the earth. But they don't trick you to believing in something else, so they taking all your lands without putting no money down. How they gonna come over here and try to buy lands up and they ain't got no goddamn money when money is fake? They stealing your lots of lands because you ain't following the laws. So when you get right by somebody, you start collecting all this group. When you got enough people together, that's what nobody do, at least they get communities. When you get communities together, you got enough of people, then you go down there and you go put your papers down and say, hey, we want to get our lots of lands. This shit real. So it's a real estate. They ain't no goddamn real estate because you ain't real. That's something gets like a heat right now because it just pissed me off. Because enough people ain't paying attention because they want to be out here still knowing law and shit because they ain't got no patience to do nothing and they ain't got enough people to be start gathering together. But that's why when I get this shit set up, you're going to see it ain't no coming because I'm going to put a lock on that door for anybody coming inside that lock.
Mm-hmm.
I'm serious. When I first came over here, I said, I want to get, look at the house is empty. I want this White House and I was going to have this like a little thing. People come in the office, like office center, set it up and people can stay in there, like rooming house, stay in there until they get their stuff together to go get their lot. Get this house, it's gonna be like with the children thing and stuff like that. Children can throw stuff like that. This is my plan. Yep, even though the brother went underestimated, went and took some, sold some shit on my back, behind my back on me. It's all good though. That's what the devil does. But it ain't over yet. All the empty lots. This is lots of land. This your boy, the super son. I gotta go come back to get heated. 13 love, 13 wisdom, 13 knowledge, and 13 right space. Let's take a quick walks around the blocks of how everything been dying off and we're supposed to be bringing it back to life. I'm out.